Hi, everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about what are called comparison operators. There are a few subcategories that fall under this, but we won't cover all of them in this lesson. What we will be talking about specifically for this one are the value comparison operators. These ones allow you to compare the ordering of values, whether one is greater than or less than the other. They also allow you to check whether values are equal or not. Here are the value comparison operators in Python. We have the less than operator, the greater than operator, the less than or equal operator, the greater than or equal operator, and then we have the equals operator, also referred to as the equality operator. Sometimes you'll also hear this called the equals equals or the double equals operator. It's used to check if two values are equal. Be careful with this one because in Python, as well as many other languages, the single equals sign is the assignment operator, which is used to assign values to variables instead. It's actually quite a common mistake to get the single equals and the double equals mixed up. And then finally, we have the not equals operator, which is also called the inequality operator. It checks if two values are different from each other. This one uses an exclamation point followed by an equals sign. Comparison operations are also binary operations. They make use of two values. You place one value to the left of the operator and the other one to the right of the operator. These comparison expressions will evaluate into Boolean values. Recall from our lesson on data types that a Boolean value can either be true or false. So for example, if you have the comparison expression 2 is greater than 1, this will check if the value on the left side of the operator is greater than the value on the right side. And 2 is in fact greater than 1, so this will give us true. If the expression said 2 is less than 1, then this will give us false instead. So let's take a look at more examples here. We have two variables, x with a value of 4 and y with a value of 3. So if we write x is greater than y, then this will give us true, because the current value of x is 4 and the current value of y is 3, and 4 is in fact greater than 3. On the other hand, x is less than y will give us false. And then x is greater than or equal to 4 will give us true. The value of x currently is not greater than 4, but it is equal to 4. So this is still going to give us true. And then x is greater than 4 will give us false. Y is less than or equal to 3 will give us true. Y is less than 3 will give us false. And then here we have the expression x equals equals y. This is going to evaluate if the values of x and y are equal. If they are, this will give us true. If not, then this will give us false. And since currently x is 4 and y is 3, then this evaluates to false. On the other hand, y equals equals 3 will give us true, because the current value of y is 3, therefore both these values are equal. And then finally, we have the expression x not equals y. This expression is going to evaluate if the values of x and y are different. If they are different, then this will give us true. But if they are equal, then this will give us false. And since x is 4 and y is 3, then the values are different, therefore this will evaluate to true. So let's run this. And here is the output as expected. We can use floats in comparison operations as well. So in this new example, we have x with a value of 2.9 and y with a value of 3.0. So if we write x is less than y, then we will get true. We can compare floats and integers as well. If we print x is less than 3, this will also give us true since the floating point value 2.9 is in fact less than the integer 3. However, you need to be careful when comparing floating point values. Let's say, for example, we compare if 1.0 is equal to 1.0. Then, as expected, this will give us true. But then let's go ahead and try to compare if 1.0 is equal to 0.5 plus 0.2 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1. You would expect this sequence of addition operations to add up to 1.0, therefore giving us a result of true. But if we execute this, this actually gives us false. Now, the reason why this happened is because of what is referred to as a representation error or a rounding error. This is because of how computers can't always represent decimal fractions with 100% precision. For now, we won't go into the details of how we can attempt to fix or work around this. We can talk about that in a future lesson. But I wanted to mention this now, just in case some of you encountered something similar and ended up with a confusing result. So don't worry, this really is something that could happen. Okay, so some more examples here. We can also compare strings. In this example, we have x with a value of hello and y with a value of goodbye. So if we write the expression x equals equals hello, then this will give us true. If we say x equals equals y, then this would give us false. The equality operator, when used on strings, will check if both string values have the exact same characters in the exact same order. And then we can also use not equals to compare strings. So if we say x not equals y, then this gives us true, since x is hello and y is goodbye. So clearly, these strings are different from each other. These string comparisons are also case sensitive. So if we say x equals equals hello with a capital H, this will give us false, since the string assigned to the variable x starts with a lowercase h instead. And now let's run this. And here we see the expected output. You can also chain comparison expressions together. For example, say we have a variable x with a value of 5, and then we say 4 is less than x is greater than 6. This one will evaluate to false, because even though this part is true, where 4 is less than the current value of x, this other part is not. The current value of x, which is 5, is not greater than 6. When chaining comparisons together, everything has to be true in order to get a final result of true. Now for this next one, each comparison will give us true, therefore the final result will be true. And then in this third example, all of the comparisons result in true, except for the very last one. So the final result will be false. So let's run this, and here we see the expected output. You can also combine arithmetic expressions and comparison expressions in one larger expression. For example, you can say x plus 1 is greater than x times 1. Arithmetic operators have a higher precedence compared to comparison operators, so their operations will be performed first before the values are compared. X plus 1 evaluates to 6, and then x times 1 evaluates to 5. And then after that, we do the comparison. Is 6 greater than 5? And that will give us true. So let's run this, and here we see the expected output. Now I just want to point out the spaces here. You'll notice that I put spaces before and after the comparison operator, but I didn't put any spaces around the plus sign and the asterisk. I'm doing this in an attempt to better illustrate the order of precedence. Since one is closer to the plus operator, then this gives us a sense that we should do the addition first before the comparison. And the same goes for this x being much closer to the multiplication operator. But you could actually remove the spaces around the greater than sign, or you could add spaces around the arithmetic operators if you wish. changing spaces will not have an effect on operator precedence. It's the parentheses that can have an effect on that, but not the spaces. And that is it for this lesson on comparison operators in Python.